What do you think about the university education? Are you facing the decision of whether to go to university or jump straight into the workforce? Maybe you're currently studying, or perhaps you've already graduated. How do you look back on it now? I graduated with a degree in mechanical engineering from CTU in Prague, and for the past 12 years, I've been working as a development engineer for a major corporate company. Today, I want to take a step back, weigh the pros and cons, and answer the question, would I do anything differently? I hope this will help those of you who are now deciding whether to go to university or are currently studying. Feel free to leave a comment below about your thoughts. I'd love to hear what you think. So without further ado, let's find out together if my CTU tech degree was really worth it, and if going to university is worth all the hype. You deepen your knowledge in your chosen field and become an expert in the subject, at least theoretically on the beginning. But companies often seek such expertise, and universities frequently provide access to the latest research and development. Seriously, what we learned at university, especially in mechanical engineering, isn't something you can learn just anywhere. Knowing how to precisely calculate the deflection of a bridge under load, when a pipe will burst under certain pressures, or how long a bearing will last, all these are invaluable skills. And I thoroughly enjoyed these lectures, especially when we had an excellent professor. That's a point for university education. The downside? I'd say, unfortunately, about 85% of the knowledge you gain, you'll never use. That's just a fact. For example, me, as a development engineer in garden technology, I've never had to calculate energy balances or use numerical mathematics in my career. And that's a small point against university education. However, this doesn't mean the knowledge is entirely useless. Even if once in a decade you realize, while solving a technical problem, that you need to calculate the lifespan of a component and consult an expert in that area, it's worth it. And if you never encountered such a problem, you might not even realize that something needs checking. This applies, I'd say, to any field, whether you're studying engineering or psychology. University enhances your ability to think critically and solve complex problems. You know how it is, at least in the Czech Republic. High school often works like this. Memorize the material, recite it for the exam, and then forget it. It's an old system. University education still has room for improvement, but you're much more on your own. No one solves problems for you. Don't want to attend lectures? Then just don't go. No one cares. You learn to handle a lot of complex issues on your own and think critically. This is a huge advantage in life. It may not always be the case, but if you choose a prestigious university like CTU in Prague within the Czech Republic, you receive interesting job offers even while still studying. And before you finish school, you'll have the opportunity to try various internships and placements in prestigious companies, allowing you to choose your dream job. And specifically for engineering, there's a huge demand for talent, perhaps even more than before as interest in the field declines, and students are literally being hunted by major companies. And these companies compete with benefits to attract students, so you can earn good money while still studying. Personally, from my third year onward, I no longer did any manual labor jobs. Instead, I worked in various companies as a junior designer while studying. And I'm pretty sure, as an engineer, whether in mechanical, electric, or nuclear, or whatever, you won't have any trouble finding a job, that's for sure. You'll spend at least another 5 years studying, unless you stop at bachelor's degree. And it will cost you, or let's say more likely your parents, quite a bit of money. Housing, food, textbooks, etc. And luckily, in the Czech Republic, education is free, so I was fortunate in that regard. And as I mentioned, you can also earn money in your field while studying, gaining valuable experience and helping your parents finance your education. Another option, is university education paid for in your country? I recommend looking into universities in the Czech Republic, Poland, Croatia. These universities may not have the famous names like Cambridge or Oxford, but you might be surprised by the quality of education you can get in Eastern countries. That said, the cost of studying are increasing year by year, which argues against going to university. By the way, on this channel I showcase everything about small businesses, present successful entrepreneurs, and provide tips on business and career development. So don't forget to subscribe so you won't miss any more videos. Now let's get back to the topic. At university, you'll meet many outstanding people, not just from your city, but from your entire country and even from around the world. Many of these individuals will be in excellent positions after graduation, providing you with numerous valuable contacts in important places. And you also find plenty of friends who share the same interests and hobbies as you. I wouldn't hesitate to say that you might even become part of an elite circle of people. Score 4-2 in favor. What do I miss the most from my university days? That's the time flexibility. Sure, studying can be very demanding at times, both mentally and time-wise, but believe me, when you're working in a corporate job post-graduation, it gets even tougher. You might have weekends off, but during the week, there's not much time outside the regular job. And that's what I loved about university. You do what you need to do, and if you're efficient and get through all your exams early in the exam period, you have quite a bit of free time, much more compared to a 9-to-5 job after graduation. Plus, usually, with a few exceptions, in your 20s, you're not yet dealing with mortgages, kids, and so on. Looking back, my university years were perhaps the best time of my life. This part may be quite subjective, but it's a fact that as an engineer, you'll likely earn above average income, no matter where you work or live. Whether it's a lot or a little, unfortunately, everyone must answer that for themselves. For some, earning 50k a year might be a dream come true, while for others, it could be a mockery they wouldn't even get out of bed for. And the fact is that salary also heavily depends on the company you work for. Salaries in multinational corporations tends to be higher, but this can come at the expense of interesting work, potentially leaving you copying data from one spreadsheet to another. And I think, unfortunately, the really interesting work, like research and development, often happens more on university campuses, and at least here in the Czech Republic. It's more for enthusiasts rather than for those seeking higher salaries. So in terms of scoring, it's more a draw here. Score 6-3. So let's go to the finals. The scoring is clear, but I think it depends. Everyone must evaluate for themselves what their values and dreams are. Going to university solely for the sake of degree and high income, that's a bullshit. Can you earn a lot of money without university? Absolutely. It depends on each personal skills. I know many people who earn much more than I do and have never set foot in a university. Conversely, university can also graduate individuals who excel at memorizing for exams, but are impractical in practice. Another example, I have a friend who is incredibly smart and at the top of his field, yet financially struggles to reach average pay. Nonetheless, he's very content because he does what he loves and opt not to join a multinational corporation. So, if someone tells you not to go to university because it's pointless for your career, they may have a point, but in terms of life experiences, that person has missed out a lot and can't objectively assess how much because they weren't there. However, if your dream is to work in Porsche's development or at SpaceX, they won't even invite you for an interview without a university education. So my recommendation, if you're not in a dire life situation where you need to earn money immediately to support your family, go study. You'll remember this period for your entire life. Besides the degree, knowledge, and career opportunities, you'll also gain many lifelong friends. To answer this question, I had to take a moment to reflect. Overall, I don't regret anything from the past. But if I were 19 again and about to start university, I would focus on two things during my studies. Firstly, I would use all that free time to build my own business. You gain a lot of experience this way, and there's a good chance you can start offering some service, like creating websites or apps. If you waste that time and try to start something while working full-time, like I do, it will be much harder. Secondly, don't rush into work too quickly. Take one or two semesters for an exchange program at a partner university abroad. Unfortunately, I didn't want to delay my graduation and finished my studies as quickly as possible, which I now believe was a big mistake. As a student, you can relatively cheaply experience living abroad and gain valuable additional experiences. So that wraps it up for today. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope I've answered some of your questions. If you have more, please leave a comment below. I'll get back to you as soon as possible. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, or follow me on Instagram, and I look forward to seeing you in the next episode.